Dr. Narendra Jadhav.
Thank you, Honorable Deputy Chairman, sir. Sir, I rise to support the Consumer Protection Bill 2019. Sir, the consumer protection rights are absolutely essential to maintain equilibrium of the marketplace and to ensure that the bargaining powers between are properly balanced between the buyers and sellers. The Consumers Protection Bill 2019 seeks to replace the Consumer Protection Act of 1986. This is a necessary step because the nature of goods and services have undergone a dramatic transformation and the e-commerce has been increasing very rapidly. Moreover, a host of services like banking, investment payments, streaming of entertainment services, they are also available online. Plus, the influence of advertisements has also increased enormously over the last two decades, and they play a major role in consumers' decision-making towards purchase of products and availing services. Sir, the 2019 bill comprehensively addresses these new concerns which have arisen over time and provides for consumer rights to mitigate these contemporary challenges and while reforming the redressal mechanism for consumer complaints. Sir, I would like to highlight three strong points of the bill and voice three concerns about this bill. First of all, the bill introduces the concept of Central Consumer Protection Authority so as to regulate matters relating to violation of rights of consumers, unfair trade practices, and false or misleading advertisements which are prejudicial to the interests of public and consumers and to promote, protect, and enforce the rights of consumers as a class. Sir, the CCPA will have powers to initiate class action, including enforcing recall, refund, and return of product. And it will reduce the burden on the courts and make the manufacturers of goods and services providers more accountable. The second strong point of this bill is that the consumer forums have been replaced by consumer disputes redressal commissions, and pecuniary limits of CDRCs which have been made higher is certainly very desirable. The third strong point is that CDRCs are authorized to entertain product liability claims, that is, a harm caused to a consumer by such defective product manufactured or sold or by deficiency in services for the purpose of getting compensation. Now I turn to three concerns that I would like to highlight. The first one, sir, is that the bill does not provide judicial members in the composition of the commission, although they exercise judicial functions. The second concern, sir, is that Section 12 of the bill provides that the acts of the central authority will be valid even if there are vacancies or defects in the constitution of the authority. This is potentially dangerous provision as it permits a powerful authority to proceed with defects and could be harmful to the interest of the consumer. Finally, sir, I would like to ask the Honorable Minister what is being done. A lot of people have talked about misleading advertisement. I need 30 seconds, sir. What is being done? I would like to ask the Honorable Minister what is being done to prevent blatant advertisements of wines and liquors pretending to be the advertisements for glasses or a pack of playing cards. This is an insult to our collective intelligence. Government should not allow these companies to get away with these kind of advertisements. Perhaps heavy taxes on the advertisements by wine or liquor may be considered. With this, I strongly support this bill and advocate its passage. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Jadhav ji.